रिकॉर्डिंग चालू कर दी। द रिकॉर्डिंग इज ऑन मैम, यू कैन।
ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन टू येट अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ नेशन वांट्स टू यू। आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल, सेफ एंड साउंड एट योर ओन प्लेसेस। सो टुडे वी हैव येट अनदर जेम ऑफ अ पर्सन अमंग अस। सो जस्ट टू लिटिल बिट ब्रीफ अबाउट दैट, टुडे वी हैव अमंग अस डॉक्टर वस्क्रमल वेस्त्रे। ओके, she is very enthusiastic, very very dynamic personality in her own field. She is one of the very great faculty member, and she is an associate professor at Department of Manufacturing and Service Industry, Faculty of Business and Industrial Development, and she works at King Mongkut University of Bangkok, Thailand. Welcome ma'am to this session.
Okay, hello.
Hello. Can you hear me, ma'am, clearly?
Yes, I can. Can you hear me?
Yeah, very good morning, ma'am, and warm welcome to this session.
Okay, good morning, Sadaf. Ravi. Okay.
How are you?
I'm good, but not really good. I'm gonna tell you later why I'm not really good. Okay.
Okay. No problem. I hope you get better soon.
Okay.
So I have some questions for you. Just to begin with, I do know a lot about you, but our audience may not know about you much. So could you please tell us a bit about yourself to all audience so that they feel connected to you? What you do basically? Something more about your own self?
Okay, actually, I'm in lecturer as a human resource management and also in business field about 15 years. I'm graduate like PhD since 2005. And actually, I have expertise in human resource management and human capital, and also some production line for manufacturing process. Yes. Something like that, but now I'm as associate professor in King Mongkut University of North Bangkok, Thailand. Yes.
Okay, that's quite a lot you do, ma'am. Very great to know. Now, ma'am, my next question would be for you. Now, this 2020 has been very devastating for us, everyone around the world. Whether it be any part of the world, it was very devastating. Everybody was shattered, locked in the house. Pandemic was really very difficult for the entire globe, professionally as well as on personal terms. Many people were not at home. They were far away from home. So I would, and our audience would really love to know, what were the biggest challenges, hurdle you faced on professional as well as personal front in this pandemic?
Great question, and I would like to share about your guys so much. I have some PowerPoint to show also, but I will show you later. And actually, for myself, I'm very sick of pandemic and COVID-19, and really challenged me because I'm like a person in Generation X, right? Not Generation Y or Generation C. So actually, I'm very low for the technology, as you know, and. In Thailand, it's not famous or it's not popular in IT or Internet of Things compared with India, right? Because India very, very good in Internet of Things or data analysis or something like that. So for me, for myself, I'm very low technology and lack of skill for information technology or something like that a lot. So I need to practice, and that very challenged me to practice to study or learn a new thing about internet, because I need to study or learn about the program such as Zoom, Google Meet, or etc. It's quite me confuse me a lot and very tough for me. But actually, I start to learn this program because it's all in my school, in my university, is like 100% online, because very, very dangerous to go out for the last year, something like that. So it's tough for instructor to teach with the online because it's lack of motivation with student and teacher, you know? And some of them, they just like log in and they go out, not listening and more practical, participant in the classroom at all. And you know, when you teach in the with the computer, someone not answer you, it's like I'm very pissed off, something like that, you know. But even if I teach in the classroom, but student can share the knowledge, we can touch the feeling, we can touch their understand or not, you know. Yeah, something like that very challenge me, and I'm very sick of COVID-19 seriously. I'm low motivation and lack of skill in technology. Yeah, but I need to learn, and now it's better because I can use a lot of things from internet, from the online class. I can serve the student because actually when I'm teach in classroom, I already give about the course material or something like that. Easy to give them to communication together and collaboration at the teamwork at the group, you know. Actually, when I'm teach in the classroom, duration for teach is like 3 hours. But when the online can teach only 1 hour and 2 hours left, they need to go to find some research and report me, something like that. Okay.
You know what? I so yeah. much resonate with you here. Me as an educator, as a teacher, even I have to do a lot of research work on my own self, a lot of new apps, technology, my student must understand. They were all demotivated how to go about it. So actually, it was a process of relearning the stuff which we have, you know, with the things we were doing. So it was kind of relearning and upgrading our own self. So, but that's what this pandemic has taught us, to relearn and upgrade our own self. Okay, so great. Yes. So this was all about your professional friend. What about your personal friend? Were you near to your family, or far away, or how you were managing conversation with them, communicating with them? So what? I mean, how you were managing this?
When I'm using the LINE application for the communication and Google Classroom. Google Classroom is like the main platform to communication with my student. And when they submit something, some the report on time or something like that, I'm also assigned all material course to the Google Classroom, okay? And I'm also share for them is about if you have some problem, like the pressure from online course or family or your friends you don't understand, you can inbox me all the time. Yeah, I can help them a lot. And for myself, I'm very, seriously, frankly, I'm sick of online class a lot. Seriously, I don't like it. I hate it. Yeah.
Okay, indeed.
But you know, anyway, sorry. Go ahead.
Our family with us in this pandemic, we were able to, because of the technology and you know, ways we were connected, that's what motivated us in this entire pandemic. Okay, now, since this situation was very drastic and terrific, everybody, whether it be student, teacher, professional, working, homemaker, everybody was struggling in their own battles. Everybody was fighting their own battles. So how did you manage to, you know, during these times and kept yourself fit and proactive? What were the things that you scheduled for yourself in the whole day? How you kept yourself to the mark and kept going in spite of a lot of hurdles that came across you?
Okay, actually, I need to proactive myself as I need to motivate myself from my deep heart. Like I need to find some material a lot, and I need to tell myself every time when I gonna getting a start a course. Like what they need to what is the best way for my student. So any practice or any exercise now I use from the USA based learning because I think it's that the good practice because it's very online hard for the USA very good. So I get some course material from them and apply to my student. And for myself, I need to motivate my myself like, hey, sometimes I'm very patient and very depressed for my exercise. And some yoga also. Yeah, yoga is very good for my brain and for relaxing. Because if you sit on the office 24 hours or in the room, you can go out. So yoga is the answer. Answer is the best answer because you can relaxing and release and, you know, for concentrate is very good. Yeah. Yoga is the best for me.
Yoga,
from video, yeah.
Great. Yeah, indeed, indeed. Yoga really helps you a lot to bring a balance between a mental mind and body. It has indeed really helped me as well. Okay, so that's what kept you motivated. Good to know that you practiced yoga. So while you were facing all these things and you were trying to cope up, communicate with your students, your people around, people with whom you were teaching. So what were the means did you utilize to connect with the people in this remote setting? How did you connect with them?
So, sorry, I can't hear my co-worker.
Co-workers, students, both. How did you manage to stay yet connected with them?
Oh, actually, family in Thailand, we use a lot of line. Same in India, because India use WhatsApp, right? But in Thailand, we use the line. I will show you because it's like, line is like this application. Yes. This
okay,
one.
Okay, that's line.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, that's line. Because in Thailand, we use this one.
Okay.
But for Indian use this one, right? Yeah. So Indian use WhatsApp.
Yeah.
In Thailand, use Line. We have the group for the student, for statistics, one group, for research, one group, and for my coworker is the one group. Because in Thailand, we use Line a lot, you know, all the time, 24 hours a day. Yeah, 24/7 day we use Line to communication together. And some if we have a big point or to like the big problem, we use the Zoom sometimes, yeah, and Google Meet, yeah. Yeah,
you
that's
know,
all.
I being an educator, when my teachers came across a problem, we used to have a meeting in the evening, we used to discuss the problem, and then we could think about the possible solutions that can be done. So I think at your friend, as well as at my friend, the collaboration was the biggest factor. To solve any problem that we are coming across, right? We were connected 24/7 on WhatsApp, on Zoom, on Google Meet, on various fronts. So this was one of the very much binding factor, the technology. The technology played a very vital role in this entire pandemic. So yes, great to know this as well. And our audience, definitely, I am very sure they are resonating with you with whatever you are saying. Now that brings me to my next question. Now, since let's hope now soon this pandemic will get over and we are going to probably go office after this physically. So what are your plans? How are you planning to go back to office and again work, you know, have an interaction with your students? What precautions are you going to take? Are you ready mentally to go to the office or your school or university and start working and interacting people physically?
Okay, now last 2 weeks we go to school already, go to university already. And you know what? The big problem is when I'm doing because this semester we did about the midterm exam already, right? And now last 2 weeks we go on inside the university. So what the problem is, you know, the problem is one of my students come to talk with me and said, hey, teacher, can you teach again from week one to week four? Because I don't understand and I don't love to join your online classroom. So the big problem is I need to review from week one to week four for my student again, you know, how sick of mine. Yeah, because they said it's like, I don't understand, because I'm teaching in statistics and research also, you know, statistics is if my student heard about the statistics, they said, oh, sick of statistics, scared for this subject. And, you know, when online class, they don't understand. So I need to start at one again now, because now in Thailand, we allow students to go to university and we teach in usually online, or no, inside class. Yeah, something like that. So that very lack of motivation for me, you know, because I need to start at one again.
Yeah, actually, I need to agree with you on this point. We all have to, again, you know, revise things that we have done. Students, even parents were like, my students are not able to understand this topic. They have forgotten. They were not present in that meeting. We were facing internet issues, so we couldn't hear you properly. So this is one of the biggest challenges I guess we all are going to face with students when we are going back. Now, are you mentally ready to go to school in spite of the fact that still we have a little bit fear of COVID-19? Are you still prepared mentally?
Yeah, because not only my student, instructor also scared because it's not 100% eliminated, right? But we have keep like social distancing, right? From example, my class have 40 students, so we divide for the two room, and one the other room is like sharing the screen, and one of the room is like live, you know, yeah, something like that. And actually, we have a lot of alcohol and we have a lot of masks, right? If you yes. cannot wear the mask, yes, you cannot go inside the cars and have alcohol gel everywhere. And when we group discussion, we like social distancing, yeah.
Okay. That,
but you know, we can protect. Yeah, sorry.
In India, the situation is
go ahead.
We opened the school for some time, but then since the situation is worsening, the schools are again closed. And as you rightly said, without checking the temperature, and you know, a lot of sanitizer was installed at every interval. So all precautions are taken, yet in spite of everything, yet there is a kind of hesitation in parents to send children to school. So are you like talking with parents on daily basis and, you know, making them aware that, okay, it's time to come back, and are you trying to prepare their mind or something?
From my experience, one of my student parents, mother, called me, like said, oh, teacher, how you can teach? Because it's still dangerous. It's not eliminated 100%, and we haven't got any vaccine. Yes, right? How you go to university? And I said, it's okay. You can online if you in the risk of area for COVID-19, because some of area is still risk. But in my university in Bangkok, it's not, you know. And I said, if you stay in other province that in the risk area of the COVID-19, you can stay home and I will teach. My parents, student parents is okay. Oh, she said, it's okay. Oh, I understand, something like that. But if they don't understand, maybe it's not happened yet, but if they don't understand, maybe we can call like make a phone by personal,
personal touch, personal connection is very much needed to communicate and you know, give them affirmations, you know, it is we properly take care in the schools, your child will be safe over there. So this kind of affirmations is very much needed in the minds of the parents. Absolutely agree with you, couldn't more agree with you on that. Okay, now probably a last, I have a lot to ask you, but then since the time will, we have a time constraint with us, my last question will be for you is that everywhere around the world, this pandemic has definitely taught us many things. Okay, so what are your takeaways, your learnings, your from this pandemic? What pandemic has taught you actually?
Yeah, for myself, you know what? It 100% pandemic, COVID-19 taught me about sharing and care together, and you need to empathize and sympathize with students and with other network, because if you lack of communication, so it's nothing, you know. And the first thing, need to empathy and sympathy we can flexible in all the time, all the during COVID-19, because you know what? Some of my students, seriously, is very bad. It's very, oh, very sad story. Some of my students call me and said, teacher, I cannot go to university anymore because my parent is, my parent have no job. Because they like, you know, they have no money to go to university anymore and need to drop this term. Yeah, and they need to go to help their parents to work. No money to university. Yeah, that's very sad. And I said, it's okay. Just stop it. And when you're ready, you go back anytime. I can help you like for follow up with your friends. Something like that. Yeah, that's very sad story. And I think this pandemic is taught me a lot. Like if I'm lack of communication with each other, so maybe misunderstanding. But the good thing, if we share or we talk or we give other with the 100% love, you will get 100% back. I think
So I guess this pandemic has taught us to empathize with each other, to share with each other, to care for each other in spite the distance we were caring, we were connected, we were calling our friends, our parents, our family members, our students. We were more connected than ever before because of this pandemic. So probably these all things were like a silver lining to a dark cloud, isn't it? Don't you agree with me?
Yeah, I agree with you. But you know what, the good thing is like I have the new friend a lot from India, you know, as your guy, you know, it's very a good thing because I can't go out from the last year. I know like the 3,000 people from Indian. Yeah, and you know, it's like Indian professor is like my second, India is like my second hometown now. Maybe I go to study in Hindi, you know.
Please, anytime do come to India. And I'm really amazed how technology, I can still be connected. Never before I was connected with the people of different areas, different places, different knowledge. I was never before I was so connected with the people. And this technology and this pandemic has given us this boon, this blessing in this entire terrific times. And this has really, you know, act as a medicine, you know, sharing and caring. Yeah. And not many people were sharing, okay, I use this, hope this is useful for you in your classroom as a lot of sharing. Caring was there, and you know, problems were solved by communicating, collaborating, connecting with the people. So indeed, so I definitely so much resonate with you. But I'm glad and thankful to the God that you are safe, your family members are safe, and I'm hoping that soon we can go back to the normal. Yes, let's move ahead with that hope that soon things are normalized. We are back to a routine. Probably we have to adapt ourselves to this new normal. We have to take a lot of precautions. Students have to be careful. We have to take certain care from our own front, and even the students have to care. But then let's adapt and adjust ourselves to the new normals. Thank you so much for your time, dear. It was indeed really pleasure. It was really indeed enlightening to talk with you. Now, audience, if at all you would like to ask something from your end, please you feel free to ask. She's really very sweet and really very beautiful as well. Nice smile.
Lily, thank you so much, Lily.
So, audience,
okay, thank you so much. Yeah.
Any question, audience, from your end? Anyone?
Nope.
Oh, I guess they definitely can resonate with whatever you have mentioned about everything. Thank you so much for your time, ma'am. Over to you, Ravi ji.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Yeah, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So shall we end the session with your permission?
Yes, yes, absolutely.
Yeah, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. It was amazing.
Same here, sir. Thank you, dear. Please stay connected. Stay safe. Stay sound. Bye-bye.